Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. How many ways to give 5 candies to 3 kids? Here, all candies are identical. Some of you may try the listing method. List all possibilities, then count the number. It is working for small numbers. If here is 500, listing method is not efficient. First, we introduce a method called sticks and stones. We have 5 candies here. Consider 5 candies are 5 stones. We use 2 sticks to divide 5 candies into 3 groups. The first group is on the left-hand side of the first stick. Second group is in between 2 sticks. The last group is on the right-hand side of the second stick. This is just one solution. First group, number of candies, that's 2. That means the first kid receive 2 candies. The second kid receive 1 candy. The last kids receive 2 candy. Look at a different solution. First group means first kids has 1 candy. Second group, we don't have candy inside. That means the second kids got 0 candy. The third kids got 4 candies. Look at another solution. On the left-hand side of the first stick, nothing there. First kids got nothing. Second kids got 3, and the last one got 2. So we can do this way, list all possibilities. So here, just to look at the question, what is the idea of sticks and stones? We consider candies are stones. So here, we have 3 kids. We only need 2 sticks to divide 5 candies into 3 groups. First group for first kid, second group for second kid, third group for the third kid. One information is very important. Number of sticks we need. We will use this information to derive the general formula. So here, if we have 4 kids here, how many sticks we need to divide 5 candies into 4 groups? We need 3. Here, we need to summarize what we have discussed here to find the result. We are not going to use listing method to count them. So here, that's a number of ways. Result, this is a result. So here, why we have this result? Look at the example here. How many items here? 5 candies, 2 sticks. Totally, that's 5 plus 2. How many sticks? We have 2. The question is equivalent to this. We have 7 seeds, 5 plus 2. We need to find 2 seeds for sticks. We have 2 sticks. Those 2 sticks, if they are in different seeds, that means the solutions are different. Each permutation corresponding to a solution. Precisely speaking, we can say this, each combination corresponding to a solution. So here, the solution is equivalent to the following. From 7, pick 2. That's a combination number. To find the 2 seats for the 2 sticks, the answer is 21. What we have discussed in the previous page, we discussed if we divide 5 candies to 3 kids, we need 2 sticks, not 3. If we divide 5 candies to 4 groups, we only need 3 sticks to divide. So here, what we have found in the previous page, that's 5 plus 2, pick 2. 5 is same 5 candies. 2 actually is related to 3. It's 3 minus 2. Because we have 3 kids, we need 3 minus 1 sticks. In general, if we have n candies, we want to give n candies to k kids. How many ways? That's number of candies plus number of sticks. Number of sticks we need to divide n candies into k group. We only need k minus 1 sticks. So here, that's to pick k minus 1 seeds for k minus 1 sticks. This is the general formula. If you know this formula, next time when you see a similar problem, less than 1 minute, you should find the answer. Similar question. This question, if we just look at the question, looks maybe that's a high level, college level, not for middle school, high school kids. How many non-negative integer solutions for this equation? Looks very complicated. 5. You have different combinations here. Pay attention to the condition non-negative integers. What are those non-negative integers? Can be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. So if we link this question to our question, 5 means we have 5 candies. 3 variables means we have 3 kids. X is the number of candy the first kids received. This for the second kids. This for the last kids. It's the same question. to give 5 candies to 3 kids. How many ways? That means how many solutions for this equation? So this question, now it's easy for you. I give you some practice questions. The first one, how many ways to give 12 candies to 5 kids? This is a combination number. The total should be 12 plus 5 minus 1, n plus k minus 1. Pick k minus 1. That's the answer, right? So here, modify the question. How many ways to give 5 candy to 3 kids if the last kids must receive at least 1 candy? That means the little kid cannot have 0 candy. How to do this kind of question? Looks difficult. Some of you maybe say that I can count all situations, just remove the case. The last kid receives 0 candy. You can do that way, but in general, we do this way. We save 1 candy there. Just give the 1 candy to the last kids first. Then what's the remaining number of candies? We have 4. So the question is, how many ways to give 4 candies to 3 kids? That's the answer. 4 candy to 3 kids, because 1 candy already gave to the last kid. How many positive integer solutions for? So here we modify the question. Original question, how many non-negative? Here, how many positive? That means x, y, z cannot be 0. Similarly to the second question, we can save 1 candy for the first kid, 1 for second, 1 for last. So here, 15 minus 3 is 12. The question is, we give 12 candies to 3 kids. How many ways? That's the way to solve this question. By the way, here, number should be number 2, number 3. Yeah. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.